Today I want to tell you about a show breed type of dog that I like the most. It's even not a Molosse, not a Rouen Terrier, because I also like that breed a lot. But if I would have a show dog, I would love to have a Shao Shao. This is Chinese type of dog. It really has that bear-like appearance that I like. Also, there are, although there are show bred type of dogs, they are really good at protecting properties. They also have a very nice acquired taste. So to say that, for example, they won't take food normally from persons that are not their own. This is a very interesting feature, and this can help a lot when someone tries to poison your dog. I'm not saying that all Shao Shaos have this, but the ones that I grew up with did, which was a very nice feature that I like. Also, they come in a variety of coats. For me, if I had to choose, you see that I have a black dog here. I would love to have a black Chow Chow, and then with a short coat. And why this decision? I think if you look at the original Chow Chow, it looks a lot more than the way the short coated Chow Chow looks. Also, the short coated Chow Chows, in my opinion, are less exaggerated. So not only the coat, but also the wrinkles in the face and snout length. And because of the day, even the short coated ones have a really good protective coat that protects them against the elements. Even really cold climates, they can really endure with that coat, and also they will have less trouble with the heat. I'm not saying that other colored Shao Shaos are not as pleasant or not a nice dog, just my personal preference. I like darker type of dogs, and I can see many advantages in the other coats and colors, especially against the heat. There are also quite some drawbacks with a Shao Shao as a short-nosed, very thick and robust type of dog. It makes it harder to breed. Also, you need to have good hips, but I like the way they look. They look like miniature bears. They also look like lions. They have a good temperament. They have a very unique feature, which is the blue tongue, which very little dog breeds have. And for me, if I wanted a dog just for looks, just for exaggeration, this would be a nice candidate. Because also, if you're going to work your dog and just show it, it's nice that you can do something with the coat instead of just brushing it. I will try to condition my Shao Shao to have a good condition. In that case, a good stamina, not too fat, good muscles. Then I think you have a very nice dog. And also, it's about the same topic that you get for a relatively little size and height, for example. You get a very big and strong type of dog. I also like that the Chow Chow has a lot of courage, so it's not a cowardly type of dog. And also, I've seen them in my youth mingle with some big badass Rottweilers, and I think the Rottweiler would have won in the end. But the Shao Shao stood his ground, and even when they were separated, was ready to go. I really liked it. And also, the Rottweiler owner told me that his dog had some severe wounds from that Shao Shao dog that he attacked. So it was a wrong decision, also for the Rottweiler. And Shao Shao was quite fine. The coat protected him quite a bit, but he had some ruptures, of course, but not a lot worse than Rottweiler had. which is, I think, it's a mean feat because the Rottweiler is like a, one of the most working type of mastiffs. Oi oi. And also still used as a character bred dog. There's a falcon in the sky. Praying to catch mice. Nice, huh? So, I was wondering what you would think about it if I didn't have him as a show dog, but just as a good companion. I think there's another breed that has a lot of Shao Shao in it that could work out a lot better. And then I would have it in a traditional Shao Shao colors. Because a multitude of reasons. One is that I really like that coloration. I also like the sesame coloration a lot. But it's quite hard to get. And color is not the most important thing. But if you could get a reddish with a dark mask Eurasian, I would like that the most. Why? Phenotypically, it has the Shao Shao looks that they use. Which means that also in looks and often in character, they will draw a little bit more to the Shao Shao side. The other breeds that were used in it are German Spitz, of the wolf Spitz type, so the biggest one with the wolf-like colors, and Samoyed to stabilize it, because the wolf Spitz Shao Shao was a little bit vicious. The dog type that I like, it had a good character, but they want to mellow it down. So it was not a vicious type of dog, but they aimed for a family type of dog. And everyone's a friend of all, instead of a dog that could be very good at protecting. And therefore the wolf show, so to say, that was the original Eurasian, has been that mellowed down by infusing some other Asian type of dog, the Samoyed, which is a very nice dog at itself. It also gives some stability in the how they look, so that not some would look very much like the German Spitz and the others like the Shao Shao, but the Samoyed is a little bit in between. Hoi, mooi dat valkje, hè? Mooi dat valkje zien, hè? Had je niet gezien op het veld? Ja, die roofvogel, prachtig. Daar hangt hij weer, zie je? Ja, heel mooi. Fijne dag nog. Ja, ik ken de valken. He's trying to pray to stand still above its prey, the mice. Or rats or whatever he's hunting. But back to the Eurasian. The benefit of Eurasian is that you get more longevity, so a bigger lifespan, also less exaggeration. And that Eurasian looks more like the traditional, original Shao Shao than even the short-coated one does. And if I had to do it, I would use the Malinois, so the Belgian one, that's the Euro component, and then the Shao Shao. And why the Malinois? Because it is very much a working breed, and then even staying with that more wolf-like Spitz-type breeds. I think if you infuse like a little bit more than a quarter of a Malinois of working lines, you could get a much better Shao Shao as a result. Also the Eurasian, especially those with those Shao Shao colorations, often carry the tongue like a Shao Shao with the blue markings on top of them. These markings come with age, just like a Dalmatian. Those pigments take some time to develop. Which is a funny thing, but Eurasian is on average a much better dog than a Chow Chow is. Not for guarding, but as an all-round family dog, which is what most people like. A little bit better health, this could be a good way to approach. The other thing is, you should note that the Eurasian has also, because of the limited gene pool, a lot of inbreeding. And even while they use three foundation breeds, so to say, so Chow Chow, Wolfsbitz, and Spice it up with some Somerjet, the gene pool was still limited. They used just a limited amount of individuals, which could hamper its health. And if you look at that condition, I think a short-coated Chow Chow would not necessarily need to be that much worse. So that's my thoughts about this show type of breeds with the blue tongue. I hope you enjoyed this video and also liked my thoughts on this matter. And I would also like to know what you want. If you would go for an Eurasian and to use two European breeds, you could also go again with Wolfsbitz, Chow Chow, and perhaps the Malinois, which I mentioned why, the reasons why. And you could go with a second breed on the side of Japan by introducing Shikoku, which is like a small Akita Inu, or the Akita Inu itself, to make the breed better and better suited and also more work related. So the Wolfsbitz in many cases is inferior to the battering capacity of a Chow Chow, even if it's that kind of exaggerated type of dog, but it's a lot more alert and also very healthy. So Wolfsbitz could still bring something to the table and also throws nice colors. It's also quite a plus for most people. The Malinois also has the same colors as the Chow Chow has, that's the dark mask. Could help and brings a lot of working capabilities to the table, whereas the Shikoku and Akita both bring a little bit more size and strength. Hoi hoi! Yeah. So. Neusje.
Ja. Ah, laat het maar. Kom, laat dan. Kom maar.
Ja, dat is flink, hè. Hoi, hoi. Just a small tail. About the dog from the leash here. This is a Patterdale Terrier, also known as a Black Veld Terrier. It's a working terrier on foxes. And badger, sometimes also on hogs. The Shikoku and Akita Inu are used on hogs, so that gives you some extra use.